joining us. My name is Dr. Gail Robertson. I'm delighted to be here today. I teach tuba and euphonium here at University of Central Arkansas. Our lowbrow day is going very, very well, but I'm concerned we have people not wearing masks. And maybe your school doesn't require a mask, but our university does. So please keep your masks on. It's kept our building open and safe. If you don't have one, we have some free masks. But yeah, do you need a mask? Do you have one? Okay, yeah. You need one? Okay. Yeah, if you can maybe... Joshua, Zach can meet you over there. Yeah, we have a kind of a strict rule here. If you're in the buildings, to wear masks. I'm off now because you can hear me, and I'll put it right back on, I promise you. Yeah, our president of the university has been really good with keeping us safe here. We've been really lucky. We have not got shut down like we thought. So, and if your school doesn't make you wear a mask, well, that's great. We have different rules. Anyway, I'm delighted to introduce our first guest artist of the afternoon. Some of you may have met him earlier today. He is the most famous orchestral tuba player that's living today. He is the tubist from the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. He is truly a hero. If you don't know me, you know I'm a dreamer. I dream big. I dream of a lot of really great things I want to do. I never dreamt this. I never had the dream that Gene Pokorny would be at UCA. So that's how big this is. You know, he's going to play some of this tuba that you're looking at here is the tuba that Arnold Jacobs played on. It is priceless. There's no value on the price of that tuba, seriously. I asked him today, how much is that tuba worth? He said, when I fly on the airlines, they want to know the value. It's probably worth more than the whole fleet of planes. So that is a very special tuba you're going to hear today by Gene Pokorny. And again, if you have not, if you don't know who this man is, it's okay. Promise me you'll Google him, not during the concert, sometime today and look and see who you got to. If you get a chance, come get your picture with him, because someday, you're going to be so glad you did. We have Gene Pokorny. Thank you.
Dixieland sousaphone player on the planet. You're not going to hear the small tuba, you're going to hear the big tuba, the contrabass tuba. These are just very interesting approximations of what the tuba can play, but they're written kind of in a jazz style because Red Lair was a jazz player. I hope you enjoy Remembrances by Mickey Robleski.
Thank you.
although he's written a lot of music for brass bands and that, and a lot of music for brass instruments, he's also written a lot of film scores. Probably the most famous film score he did was for the movie Silverado, one of the great westerns of all time. If you get us have a chance to go to YouTube and just put on the soundtrack, the theme to Silverado, you're in the Wild West. It's one of the greatest film scores that was ever written. But he's written The Prodigal Son, he's written the young Sherlock Holmes, Lost in Space, the movie, and done a lot of scoring and that for films all over. But he does occasionally write music for various players. This particular piece was written for Aaron Tyndall, who's down in Florida. The most famous piece that Bruce wrote for tuba was written for my teacher, Tommy Johnson, who did a lot of soundtracks in Hollywood. It was, I think it's called Sonatina or Concertino, but it's used on a lot of competitions in that, so you might recognize that. So I very much appreciate being invited by Dr. Gail Robertson to be here for the Low Brass Festival here and for the last couple of days here with the here at the university. And I look forward to coming back sometime. You know, I haven't been to all the donut shops yet, so, but I want to catch a couple more. So here we go with Turbulence by Bruce Broughton. Thank you.
Trying to get Yu Tamaki to the U.S. for about 3 years now. This started back in 2019. He was supposed to be an artist at the International Tremolo Festival at Ball State University in Muncie, Indiana. I mentioned the wrong date last night, by the way. He flew into Detroit, headed to the festival the week of the festival. His visa was messed up for whatever reason. They put him back on a plane and sent him back home to Tokyo, Japan. By the way, I found out later, a pit stop in Paris where he had to stay in a holding cell. So, gotta love visa issues. A year and a half later, a small little pandemic worldwide, and we have figured out how to get him back into the United States of America. This is his second visit of four this school year. He started in the fall a couple weeks ago. He was at Manus, Manhattan, Juilliard, and then stopped, went over to Ball State, flew over to Indianapolis, went to Ball State, and then flew back home to Tokyo. Now he's here, he's visiting us, he's going to Southern Mississippi after this. And then flying home to see his girlfriend for the first time in almost 2 years in Denmark because of COVID. And then is coming back in the spring for another round of visits, and then we'll be back on our campus this summer at the International Tremolo Festival. He's an artist for the ITF this summer. So we're trying to keep him pretty busy in the U.S. now that he has a functioning visa and we can use it and abuse him. So I think you're going to be thoroughly impressed by his playing. He's got some different pieces today, plus a little video game music to finish the show. So please enjoy Yu Tamaki and Kazuo Murakami.
Thank you. so many places, he took many, you know, influence elements. You know, the carnival of animals, you know that piece. Because he went to all those different countries, saw those animals. And this piece particular, he wrote on the ship. And I heard he didn't hear this piece himself. But I don't know if it's true, but this is a beautiful piece. Following to that, we're going to play it to you. It is
Thank you.
exciting video game feeling into trombone playing. And I looked for this composer on the field for video game and anime in Tokyo. And I was introduced to this lady. She works for many animation companies and video game companies. She writes specifically for anime and video. And this music is only 4 minutes, but has three parts. And it is actually a journey of the history of video game. It starts with the 70s, like a very limited sound effect. And it goes into some Nintendo, Super Nintendo era. So it's a little more sound. And it becomes more like a PlayStation, like a 5, you know, the very new with full orchestra sound. So you can see the development of the video game music, and also with this really nice picture and a sound system. Happy New Year. Thank you.